Good morning, children. In the previous lecture, we have done the tabular presentation of data. Now, this chapter again deals with presentation of data, but it is in a different form, that is diagrammatic presentation of data. Now, earlier I've told you that main function of statistics is to present the data in the, or present the complex data in the most simpler form, so that it is very easy to understand. Even the layman can understand the statistics or the data without much effort. That is the main function of statistics. Now, earlier we have taken that how the classified data is presented in the form of tables. Now, this chapter is dealing the presentation of data in the form of diagrams. Now, that does not mean that table is of less of importance or which one is better. You cannot say that in comparison to table or in comparison to tabular presentation, diagrammatic presentation is better. Though it is good, it is better in the sense that it gives a bird's eye view and it is attractive. But without tables, diagrams cannot be drawn. So both are equally important, and you can say that diagrammatic presentation is like a substitute for tabular presentation. But both are equally important, because without table or without the classified data, you cannot draw the diagram. Otherwise, without classified data, diagram will be haphazard or it will not be clear. So both are equally important, but these are two different ways of presenting data. Now, diagrammatic presentation, what we have taken here, the presentation of data by diagrams. Now, diagrammatic presentation is a bird's eye view. Through diagrams, you present the data in the most simple and attractive manner, so that without much effort, even the layman or even the person who has little knowledge of statistics can learn the data and make the analysis. This is our main purpose of drawing diagrams. Now we see, or we come to this, what is the meaning of diagram first? We'll see this. Here, a diagram is a visual form of presentation of statistical data. So diagram is a visual form, that in the visual form, the data is presented. The statistical data is presented in a visual form. That means through diagram, immediately you can visualize what is the data. And you know, when the diagram gives the data, then it becomes more attractive also. So the meaning of diagram, you can say, it is a visual form of presentation of the statistical data in an attractive manner. Right? Now, this is the meaning of a diagrammatic presentation. Now, after this, after understanding the meaning, let us come to the importance of diagrams. Right? What is the importance of diagram, or why diagrams are drawn to present the data? First is, diagrams are helpful in communicating the meaning of complex facts or complex numerical data. You know, the data, when it is collected, as I told you earlier also, it can be in thousands or it can be in lakhs also. Because when you are collecting the data about the census of India, then we'll give you a very long figure. It is a big, because India is a highly populated country. So in this way, data can be in small figures or it can be in large figures. Similarly, when you are finding out the agriculture production in India, then you know that there are many crops grown. So collecting data of each and every crop, that is a difficult task. But when the data is collected and you are presenting the data, then this is another difficult task. Distribution, what you are showing in a complex form, that distribution can be made easy with the help of diagram. So this diagram is helpful in communicating the complex numerical facts in a very simple and attractive manner. So this is one importance of drawing diagram. Second, diagrams facilitates analysis and comparison. How? Because when you're drawing the diagram, so diagram is giving a comparison. Like suppose you are comparing the agriculture production of different states. And through diagram can be in the form of bar graph or pie diagram. Now, if the diagrams, what you're drawing, they are giving you the crop production in a particular state, then with the help of the bar, suppose you have drawn the bar diagram, with the length of the bar, you can make out which state is having more production and which state is having less of agriculture production. So in this way, comparison becomes easier with the help of diagram. And when comparison becomes easier, obviously, the analysis of data can be also easier. And our purpose of learning statistics is how to analyze the data in the easiest manner. So by drawing diagrams, another benefit what we are getting, or what is the importance, facilitates analysis and comparison. Right? These two points are clear. Now we come to the third one. Diagrams gives more satisfactory results. What do you mean by this? Because if you compare diagrams with tables, tables also give you the classification of data and the figures are shown in a clear form. But in comparison to tables, diagrams are more satisfactory. Why? Because in the table, you have to go through the table or you have to compare the figures. But by diagram, by drawing the lines or bars, easily you can draw the conclusions and you can get the satisfaction that you have understood what is shown in the diagram. So this way, diagram gives you more satisfactory results, right? So that solves your purpose. Fourth is appealing to the eye. Obviously, anything when it is shown in the form of diagram or graph, that is always more attractive. Why? Because it appeals to the eye. Appeals to the eye means immediately it draws your attention and you want to just look at it and try to understand the diagram. So diagrams in comparison to tables, they are definitely more attractive. But as I told you, first you have to make the table, then only on the basis of diagram you can do the analysis. So both are going side by side. But tables does not draw so much of attention as the diagrams. So along with the tables, if you draw the diagram, that becomes more meaningful, right? Next is, diagrams does not require special knowledge of statistics. As I told you, that diagrams are considered good even for the layman. You understand what is meant by layman? A person who does not have any special knowledge. Now, statistics is such a subject that it is not necessary that everybody knows statistics, right? Statistics does not mean only figures. It means how to analyze the figures, how to interpret the figures. That is statistics. Now, layman who does not have knowledge of statistics, then it is difficult for him to read the table. But it is easier for him to go through the diagram, because the diagrammatic presentation will give the message to the person what the person wants to show through the diagram. At least some impression he will get and he will try to understand with the help of diagram, and definitely he will be getting some information out of the diagram if the diagram is drawn properly. So another importance of diagram is that even the layman can understand it who does not have special knowledge of statistics, right? So another importance. Next is, it saves time in analysis and presentation of data. If the table, long table is given, that is little time consuming. Or if the data is given in an unclassified way, then also it is time consuming. But if the data is given in the form of diagram, it saves time in making analysis and presentation of data. Right? So this shows the importance of diagrams in statistics. Right? Now, after learning all this, you must be curious to know what are diagrams, different type of diagrams, because then only you will understand how the diagrams have so much of importance. Now here we'll take different types of diagram. First type is bar diagram. Bar diagram are drawn on the basis of the data given, and each numerical value is given in the form of bars, and the comparison of numerical value is done with the help of length of bars. The bar which is showing greater length, that is given a higher value, and which is showing lesser or which is a short bar, that is showing the smaller value. So length of the value, bar diagrams are drawn on the basis of length. So length of the value makes the comparison of numerical value easier. So bar diagram, this is one type of diagram which is on the basis of length of bars, right? Second is area diagram. Area diagram means anything which is drawn, then length and breadth of bars, you can say, or length of breadth of any diagram, any type of presentation what you're giving, that gives you the total numerical comparison, or numerical values are compared on the basis of area in the diagram. And how do you get the area? Length into breadth. So numerical values here are compared on the basis of length and breadth of the diagram, or you can say the area of the diagram. These are known as area diagrams. Third is volume diagram, in which the numerical values are compared on the basis of length, breadth, and height. Right? So the whole volume is taken into consideration, and in this the, you can say, cubes, or cubes are example of volume diagram, or spheres or cubes, they give you the volume. Now in our statistics subject, what you are in 11th class, you are learning, then you are concerned with bar diagram only. This is not included in our study, so we will not consider this in detail. So one thing, that is bar diagram on the basis of length, that is only we are dealing with, right? Area diagram and volume diagram, you need not go in detail. Now I'll take you example, I'll give you one example of bar diagram. What are bar diagram? Bar diagram, as I told you, they are drawn in the form of bars. They can be drawn vertically or they can be drawn horizontally, both ways. Now first we'll take how the bars are drawn vertically with the example. Now here there's one example. Draw a vertical bar diagram to represent the given figures relating to manufacturing of cars. Now this table is given to you. The figures are given in the form of a table here. These figures give you the detail about manufacturing of cars in a particular region. Now here the years are given and number of cars are shown here. Now years 2008, 2009, 10, 11, 12 and 13, and the number of cars in each year in thousands, right? So cars we are showing here, not only 150, but all the figures are in thousand. Now for drawing the diagram, what we'll do, you'll draw two axes, OY and OX axis, as it is drawn here. On the OY axis, you will take the variable, that is cars, number of cars in thousand. Now when you draw the diagram, always you have to, for bar diagram, you have to draw two axes. And OY is the vertical axis, OX is the horizontal axis. Remember this. If you write x over here, that will be wrong. O y will be vertical. O x will be the horizontal axis. Now here, number of cars are taken on the vertical axis, and years we have taken on the x axis, that is horizontal axis. Now secondly, when you draw the axis, you have to divide the axis into equal parts. How to divide, or how to decide that how many parts you have to take, or what description you, or what data you are going to show on this axis? Now on the vertical axis, where you are showing number of cars, for this first you see that what is the minimum number over here and what is the maximum, right? Here the maximum data is 280. That means you can take from 0 to 300. If you take more than that, there will be wastage of paper, right? And you need the figures from 0 to 300. Though you do not have figure between 0 to 100, but equal division you have to make over here. So you will take from 0 to 300 and divide this axis in equal parts. For proper diagram, there should be equal distribution starting from 0. And the interval will be the same in each case here. As I have taken here, this is 50, then 100, then 50. That means gap of 50. You should not take these figures. Otherwise, it will be wrong. You have to divide the axis equally. Because when you're dividing the axis, you have not drawn the bars. Bars are drawn on the basis of these figures, but not the axis. Only the upper limit is considered over here. That tell what figure we need to take the length of bar, right? Now, OX axis, that is showing the years. Here again, 2008 is the first one and the last is 2013. So accordingly, we divide it into equal parts here, right? 2008 and 2013 till here, we'll divide the axis. Now after this, after dividing the axis in equal parts, and another thing, don't forget to label the axis. Because if you do not label the axis properly, then your diagram has no meaning. And in the exam also, when you draw the diagram, if you do not label the axis, you do not name the axis, you will get zero. So labeling of diagram is very important. Until and unless you label it, nobody can understand the diagram, what does it show, right? So, OY axis will label number of cars in 1000, as it is given here. Same way, this axis will name as years, as given in the data. Now, the next step, what is, you just read the data and accordingly draw the length of bars. For example, 2008, number of cars are 150. So draw a line till 150 and make a bar like this. Second is 100, again draw a line and make a rectangle like this. All rectangles are known as bars here. Now, according to data given here, for each year, you are supposed to draw the bars according to their numerical value and taking this into consideration. Now, one thing I should tell you here, always remember that when you are drawing the bars, these bars should be of equal width. It should not be such that one bar is very broad and one is narrow. All the bars should have equal width. That means width-wise, they are equally broad, right? As you can see here. But the length of the bar, how it is governed? It is governed on the basis of these figures. So width will be the same, whatever you take. But length will be on the basis of this given data. This is clear. Now, again, I want to tell you here that when you are taking the width of the bars, although it should be the same, but don't make the bars which are unusually broad or which looks very broad, because obviously the diagram will not look very good, because the shape of the diagram or the appearance of the diagram is also equally important. So you have to present the diagram in a beautiful manner, right? So take the breadth of the or width of the bars which is appealing to the eye. So remember